World Music Time and the Ron Riley Show. Elvis Presley going to make this the second of three in a row. If I can dream, I want to dream about you. There must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in the sky. More blue. If I can dream of a better land.
21 degrees under cloudy skies in Chicago. That meeting between the Board of Education and the Chicago Teachers Union is over now. They talked over a new contract, which hopefully will avert a teacher's strike. The two sides, though, are still not in agreement. They'll meet again tomorrow at 9:30 in the morning. This news, a presentation of the Public Service Department of WLS. Good evening. I'm Dick Harley, WLS News. Chicago Police Sergeant Lewis Jones in critical condition tonight. He was shot three times earlier today by a gunman in a South Side police station. Jones said a man identified as 42-year-old Fred Williams entered the Prairie Avenue station and fired four shots from a pistol. Jones said Williams didn't say a word, just opened fire. Police still tonight trying to figure out why. The FBI announced the capture today in Chicago of 23-year-old Harold James Evans. Evans had been on the FBI's 10 most wanted list since June of last year. He made a dramatic escape at that time from a Norristown, Pennsylvania courtroom. A fire in a home in Chicago's South Side today left two young children dead tonight. The victims identified as 5-year-old Cheryl Hassel, her 2-year-old brother Herman. The children pronounced dead after being rushed to Englewood Hospital. The cause of the blaze, undetermined. 30 high school seniors went through some of the paces tonight in suburban Niles at the Mill Run Playhouse. It's all part of the preliminaries leading up to the crowning Saturday night of the new Illinois Junior Miss. Tonight and tomorrow night, the hurdles are performances involving talent, poise, appearance, and youth fitness. Tomorrow night, WLS News will have reports on the Illinois Junior Miss pageant. Security preparations still underway tonight for President-elect Nixon's visit tomorrow to Chicago. The Secret Service working with the FBI and local police to ensure Nixon's safety. WLS News talked with Sergeant Joe Cuddy of the police department. We asked how much work they'll be doing in connection with those security arrangements.
On this specific occasion, I don't know what we'd be expected to give, but I know one thing, it would be 100% cooperation with the Secret Service.
Nixon coming for a bipartisan dinner honoring the three Chicagoans named to the new cabinet. WLS News Time, 10:27. Four prisoners have released the three hostages taken during a jailbreak. It happened earlier near Jackson, Mississippi. The hostages were not hurt. Overseas, two of three United States soldiers freed from Viet Cong captivity on New Year's Day are now on the way home. In the war, in the worst scattered enemy strikes throughout South Vietnam, 12 Vietnamese civilians dead tonight. It happened in a mine blast. Central 6-0507, WLS News means $89 for the best news tip each month. The snow is still with us. WLS Chicago weather next. That's an old 78 RPM record. Sounds pretty bad compared with what we have now. But to a child born deaf, a victim of birth defects, even that scratchy sound would be sweet music. Today, there are many children born deaf who are being trained to talk and in some cases to hear thanks to the March of Dimes. And you can help too. Give to the Chicago area March of Dimes and join the fight to prevent birth defects. WLS Chicago weather, cloudy and warmer tonight and tomorrow. Chance of light snow, a low tonight around 13. Madison has snow and 14 degrees. WLS lakefront temperature 24. O'Hare reports 21 and officially Midway has 21. Dick Harley, reporting for WLS.
Gone cold. 89. The beat goes on.
89 WLS.
Say, man, they tell me you think you're pretty good. Don't you know you're in my neighborhood? They tell me you're pretty bad on your feet. So I want you to meet me at the dance hall on Market Street. You hear?
Show. Final score, Bradley 109 and North Dakota 77. In the NBA, the Atlanta Hawks took the Bulls tonight 106-88.
When you've got a job to do, reach for something good to chew. Chewing helps you stand the pace anytime and any place. So,
chew Wrigley Spearmint Gum. That lively flavor freshens your mouth, and the good chewing helps make the job go smoother and faster. Enjoy Wrigley Spearmint Gum every day.
Hi-ho, hey, hey, chew your little troubles away. Hi-ho, hey, hey, chew Wrigley Spearmint Gum.
Right now it's just 10:35, LS Most Music Time.
89
into my eyes. Lord knows the man's a fan, the only one who could ever be.
Chicago, second of three in a row. WLS Souvenir, number one in June of 65, the four times. WLS. Double Souvenir. on my fire, the Doors.
Last year, it killed almost as many Americans as all of World War II. It is the quiet killer, the cigarette. Write for your free copy of Smoking and Illness, United States Public Health Service, Washington, D.C., 20201. Do it now. Life is too short to let yourself go up in smoke.
Chicago weather.
Clouds going to hang around, warmer temperatures, and tomorrow's going to be maybe a little snow during the day. Right now, the low tonight will be 13, a forecasted high tomorrow, 20 degrees. Beneath those cloudy skies, I have 23 WLS degrees.
89 WLS.
Condition red. Don't you come over tonight, 'cause mommy and daddy don't approve of you and me getting too tight. Why doesn't he get a haircut? Why doesn't he shave? You know, he used to be such a nice looking fellow before he grew that awful beard.
me up, Buttercup. I'm just sitting around here waiting on you. If you want to do something that really counts, here's a reminder from the jocks of the Big 89. If you'd like, why don't you volunteer, be a marching mother, show a handicapped child that you really care. Volunteer for the Mother's March of Dimes today.
Taste that beat, speed of the storm.
One LS Most Music Time. Mr. Wilson's taking a step in and hit.
Hey, Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let it in your heart. Then you can start to make it better.
Thank you.
23 degrees under cloudy skies in Chicago. A six-year-old girl, Paula Marshall, is dead tonight. She was killed by a car. She was running across Humboldt Boulevard to buy her mother a package of cigarettes. The youngster is the third person to die in Chicago traffic since New Year's Eve. This news, a presentation of the Public Service Department of WLS. Good evening. I'm Dick Harley, WLS News. A maintenance man is dead tonight after he fell 20 feet from the Curtis Candy Company sign on North Water Street today. The 44-year-old victim, Edward Duffy, died in Henrotin Hospital tonight, about 12 hours after he lost his footing. He was cleaning the sign when he fell through a maze of girders and landed on the roof of a five-story building. The school board met tonight with officials of the Chicago Teachers Union. They're still trying to reach a contract agreement in time to avert a strike. No word on any progress or lack of it. More talks scheduled for tomorrow morning. A two-year-old boy being carried across the street by his mother was killed today by a truck. The mother is in serious condition tonight at a hospital. She tried to save the youngster. The incident happened at 25th and North Avenue. The boy identified as Miguel Rosa, who lived on North Maplewood. Firemen were able to see two young children trapped by smoke and flames in a building, but were unable to get to them in time. It happened during a fire today at 55th and Shields. The youngsters who are dead tonight, two-year-old Herman Hassel and his five-year-old sister Cheryl. The cause of the fire undetermined, but officials say it may have been started by children playing with matches. A group of high school students from Skokie are helping a 24-year-old housewife live tonight. Mrs. Earlene Montgomery, a mother of four, is the first to use a new kidney machine. It was given to County Hospital by members of the Denise Joe Collin Memorial. 16-year-old Miss Collin died 2 years ago of a kidney disease, and a group of her friends raised money to buy that machine in tribute to her. WLS News asked Mary Barr at County Hospital if the gift is unprecedented.
Yes, this is an unprecedented gift. It has enabled us to start our first dialysis unit, and it is, we hope, the beginning of a tradition of gifts to County Hospital, because County is as badly in need of gifts as any of the private hospitals.
Ms. Barr says the new machine may help Mrs. Montgomery, who is a twin, become the hospital's first kidney transplant. It may take time, but the machine, says Ms. Barr, means life. Also in Chicago, concerning hospitals, the first successful transplant patient doing well enough that he feels like going home. Details from a spokesman at Presbyterian St. Luke's Hospital.
Doctors at Presbyterian St. Luke's Hospital report this afternoon that Mr. Irvin Kramer, heart transplant patient, is continuing to gain strength and is in good condition. Mr. Kramer has been out of bed several times today and continues to eat solid foods.
Kramer, meanwhile, is beginning to develop an enormous appetite.
Today he had two TV dinners rather than his usual one because he continues to complain about being hungry. As of this time, there is no sign of rejection of the organ.
A condition report on Irvin Kramer from a spokesman at Presbyterian St. Luke's Hospital. An autopsy report revealed today in Los Angeles that Marina Elizabeth Habe, the 17-year-old actress daughter of a novelist, was beaten and stabbed to death. The girl's body found near a major Los Angeles street. WLS News Time, 10:59. Three small children and a 106-year-old man burned to death today. It happened when fire destroyed their home in southeast Texas. In California, newsman Bob Scott tells WLS News the Apollo is back home.
The spaceship was designed and built by North American Rockwell Corporation. We asked Harry Peck, the post-flight project engineer, how the exterior of the ship fared on its fiery return through the atmosphere. Peck said,
beautiful. Real beautiful. It's about the same as the spacecraft 17 flight, which I believe is Apollo 2 or 1. And that re-entered at almost the same speed that this spacecraft re-entered, and the char, a cursory check of the char, appears very similar.
Beck also said the most expensive of the internal systems of the Apollo 8 will be reused.
In Paris tonight, procedural questions still stalling the beginning of expanded Vietnam peace talks. In the war, 12 Vietnamese employees of the U.S. military killed. It happened when they hit a communist mine near Da Nang. We're still in the snow belt. WLS Chicago weather next.
What's the grooviest thing going today? Go Mod. M-O and a D. That's the March of Dimes, the leader in the movement to prevent birth defects.
Birth defects happen every other minute of every day, 250,000 times each year. So what can you do? Go MOD and join the Chicago Area Birth Defect Protest March, the March of Dimes. You've got a bigger stake than anyone because you're the parents of tomorrow. Because what we're really talking about is the health of your children and their children, too. So go MOD. Give to the March of Dimes.
WLS Chicago weather, cloudy and warmer tonight and tomorrow. Chance of light snow. A low tonight near 13. Green Bay has snow and 6 degrees. WLS lakefront temperature 25. O'Hare reports 21. And officially Midway has 23. Dick Harley reporting for WLS.
Beside me.